Welcome you to our part two of the treatment of unrealized profits under group accounts. Remember, in our first part, there was a scenario question one, which I used to show you how to make the adjustments in the consolidated financial statements. However, in this case, we have scenario two and scenario three. So I'm going to show you how to still make the adjustments in the consolidated financial statements in respect of unrealized profits under group accounts. This is Senior Huntington, don't forget. Now, scenario two. During the financial year ended 31st July 2019, Moran, a subsidiary company, sold goods to Lorry for 30 million euros. So you see there is intra-group trading even in this scenario. These goods were sold at a markup on cost of 100%. Of these goods, 40% remained in inventory of Lorry at 31st July 2019. 2.5 million euros of the cost of these goods remain unpaid by Lorry at 31st July 2019. Advice on the adjustments to be made when preparing the consolidated financial statements. So we see there is an intra-group trading and part of the goods are still in inventory of the parent company. So you expect unrealized profit adjustments to be made. But remember, there is also an intra-group balance, a current account balance of 2.5 million euros. We are going to see how to deal with these 2.5 million euros in the financial statements of the group. Remember, we have to make our adjustments in the consolidated statement of profit or loss, as well as in the consolidated statement of financial position. This time, the examiner has used a markup of 100%. Remember, a markup is a profit percentage on cost. So we are going to see how to deal with markups when computing unrealized profits. We're also going to see how to use margins. Remember, in our scenario one, it was not margin and markup. They just gave you the total sales value of the goods as well as their cost value, whereby you want to find out the profit by getting the difference between the sales value as well as the cost. But in this case, the examiner is using a markup. So you are going to see how to use markup. Now, in the statement of profit or loss for the group, remember, we are supposed to add the revenues of the two companies. So get the revenue of Lorry as well as the revenue of Moran and add them together. But don't forget, we have to eliminate the intra-group revenue of 30 million euros. So add together then minus 30 million euros. Cost of sales, we still do the same thing. Add together the cost of sales figure of the parent, that is Lorry, as well as Moran, the subsidiary company. But don't forget to minus the 30 million euro, the intra-group purchase. The subsidiary records a sale, the parent company records a purchase. So eliminate them, reduce revenues as well as cost of sales. Don't forget, part of the goods remain unsold at the year end. So the unrealized profit must also be computed since part of the goods remain unsold at the year end. Now, in this case, they are using the markup. So for you to get the unrealized profit on inventory, always get the markup, that is 100 over markup plus 100%, so that will give you 200%, then times the sales value of the goods. You can see the formula there on the screen. Now, what was the total profit made on the trade? We get our markup, which is 100 over 200 times the sales value, 30 million euros. So meaning that 15 million was the profit that was made on this intra-group trading. However, 40% of the goods remain unsold at their end. So we have to calculate the unrealized profit for the 40% inventory. So meaning that since I have the total profit of 15 million, I just subject the 40%, 15 million, to find out the profit that has not yet been realized by the group. This should be eliminated by reducing the retained earnings of the seller company, that is Moran, and the group inventories in the statement of financial position. Don't forget. Therefore, in the consolidated statement of profit or loss, add this unrealized profit of 6 million euros to the cost of sales figure. When you add the 6 million to the cost of sales figure, the cost of sales figure increases. And when cost of sales figure increases, profits will reduce. Don't forget that. In the consolidated statement of financial position, remember we still have to get the current assets of the group. We add them together. That's parent subsidiary. So under the current assets, add together the inventories of both companies, but don't forget to deduct the unrealized profit of 6 million to match with the requirements of IS2 inventories of measuring inventories at the lower of cost and net realizable value. Remember, we have to adjust our retained earnings, which will depend on who the seller company is. Since the subsidiary is selling, reduce the retained earnings of the subsidiary by 6 million. So the adjustment to make is debit group retained earnings or cost of sales for that unrealized profit, and then credit inventory in the statement of financial position. There is an intra-group balance outstanding of 2.5 million euros. Remember, these companies are likely to sell to each other on credit. So one company recognizes a receivable, the other company recognizes a payable in their individual financial statements. But when it comes to the group financial statements, such intra-group balances should be eliminated. So simply eliminate the 2.5 million euros by reducing the trade receivables and payables in the group. Scenario 3. Now here in scenario 3, they are using gross margin. In the scenario 2, we saw that they had used markup, and you see the formula to use. So in this case, we are also going to see how to use margin to come up with the unrealized profits. During the post-acquisition period, Corib, a subsidiary company, sold goods to Allen for 4 million euros. These goods were sold at a gross margin of 25%. Remember, gross margin is profit percentage on the selling price. So the goods were sold at a gross margin of 25% of transfer price. 30% of the goods remain in the inventory of Allen on 31st July 2017. Advice on the adjustments to be made when preparing the consolidated financial statements. Remember, we have to calculate the unrealized profits on those goods that remain unsold. And this unrealized profit should be eliminated from the group point of view. Intra-group trading. Eliminate the intra-group sale or purchase. 4 million in full from the group revenue as well as group cost of sales. That is the consolidated statement of profit or loss adjustment. Then the statement of financial position, closing unrealized profit provision required. We have to calculate that. So we see that the top profit on the intra-group trading is 25% over 100 times 4 million. That will give you the total profit. But remember, it's only 30% of the goods that remain unsold. So meaning that the profit I need is for the 30%. So get 4 million times 25 over 100. Remember, it's 25%. So it will be 25 over 100. Then times 30%, which gives you 300 million euros. Deduct this from group inventories in the statement of financial position for the group, and also adjust the retained earnings of the subsidiary company by 300 million. Remember, the double entry, debit the retained earnings of the seller company, that is 300 million, then credit group inventories in the statement of financial position for the group. Thank you for watching. We invite you to join our CPA classes for all sittings of 2021. March sitting, June sitting, September, as well as the December sitting. Talk to us by calling on that number. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye.